In this animation, we'll consider electromagnetic waves and their common features. Imagine this. You've settled down for the evening. You're feeling the heat from a warm fire hit your face. With your TV remote, you flick through some potential movies. You can hear and smell popcorn popping in your microwave in the background. The fire, the TV remote, and the microwave, all these are examples of energy travelling in the form of electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves are made up of two constituent waves that oscillate perpendicular to each other. One is an electric field, and the other is a magnetic field. They both move in the direction of propagation. Here are four fundamental properties of these waves: speed, wavelength, frequency, and amplitude. First up, speed. One property that differentiates electromagnetic waves from mechanical waves is that they can travel through a vacuum. The speed of an electromagnetic wave in a vacuum is constant at 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. The waves have troughs, the lowest points, and crests, the peaks. The distance between two troughs or two peaks is known as the wavelength. Frequency is closely related to wavelength. Frequency is the number of waves per unit time. The SI unit for frequency is hertz. 1 hertz is the number of waves per second. Frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional. The longer the wavelength, the smaller the frequency, and vice versa. Following the equation frequency equals speed, C, divided by wavelength, lambda. Finally, there's amplitude, the maximum displacement of a wave from its central axis. Amplitude is associated with the intensity of the wave. Electromagnetic waves can be classified according to frequency, from radio waves on one end of the spectrum to gamma rays on the other. Frequency increases as you go from left to right. Since they are inversely proportional, that means wavelength decreases. Radio waves and microwaves on the left have lower frequencies. Visible light, the kind we can see with our eyes, makes up only a small fraction of the spectrum. On the right are higher frequency waves, like UV and infrared, and X-rays. Frequency is proportional to energy, so these waves are higher energy. These can harm humans, hence why it's important to wear sunblock, and why X-ray technicians wear protective equipment. In quantum physics, light can be considered like particles carrying light in energy packets called photons. The energy of each photon in an electromagnetic wave can be calculated according to the equation E equals HF, where H equals a constant, Planck's constant, with a value of 6.63 times 10 to the minus 34 joules per second. Let's try using this equation. Say an electromagnetic wave has a wavelength of 400 meters. How much energy is in each photon? First, write the equation for the energy of an electromagnetic wave, E equals HF. Since we know F equals C over lambda, substitute this in. Now, fill in the values. Planck's constant, the speed of light, and the wavelength. The value of energy E is E equals 4.97 times 10 to the power minus 28 joules. We hope you now understand what electromagnetic waves are and how to calculate their properties. Why not try out some more practice questions to build your confidence? Hit subscribe for more informative videos like this one.